Hi guys, I'm back with another video. I was initially going to scrap these two photos and I had already started pulling papers for my mini kit, Monday kit. And then I decided that I wanted to use a layout. And so I went into my printouts of layouts that I have and I went to this page maps and I'm using layout number 6 from the August 2018 page maps. They have a website where they have these free printables. I was drawn to this one right here. I don't know that I'm gonna add the title here, but I'm going to try to stick to it as close to as possible. It seems like it's a fall theme because it has leaves, but I'm not going to use that and you'll see that in my layout. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started. I'll have this right in front of me so I can see it. And what I'm gonna do is I'm not going to use these papers, I don't think at all. I'm not sure yet, maybe this one for sure, because it reminds me of Waves. It's from the Willow Lane collection, but I am using several of the Maggie Holmes collections. And so I went into the Sunny Days stuff that I had in the Mini Kit Monday kit and I decided also to go into the project pad that I have. I didn't include this in my kit, but since it is from the Sunny Days collection, I just went ahead and decided that I'm going to use it. Now these two pages are not from the collections. They're from two different collections, but they are from Maggie Holmes and so they're very similar. This color is very similar to this, even if it isn't like completely matched up. It is a similar color, so I think I am going to decide to use that color, but I do need to bring in something else. So I'm going to go ahead and get started by cutting pieces of this. This is what I want on the edges of the 12x12, which is right here. I want the seashell paper over on these two sides. Because they are pictures from the aquarium, I kind of wanted to give something that kind of relates to that. And with the various amounts of pattern paper that I picked out, I don't have very many that specifically say aquarium. I have more so the type that say beach and summer, but I'm going to kind of relate the two because the aquarium stuff mainly is from the ocean, right? So we're gonna go with that. And I'm gonna go ahead and put you in fast forward.
Okay, so right off the top, I do start with the looking for that dye because even though there are elements in the sketch that I don't go and use, I do try and follow this sketch as much as I can. And like I said, I did grab this from the page map sketch, free sketches. They're from August 2018. I did end up keeping this one page right here because it does remind me of waves in the water. And in the photographs, if you can see, there's a lot of the part where they're not waves, but you can see the top of the water from underneath. They're under in this like hollow tube where you can see all the fish, which I really think is awesome. I don't think I've been to an aquarium like that. I can't recall though, to be honest. I do add several of these elements that it doesn't really call for all on the bottom, and it's just because this is a new type of style of layout for me where it just kind of covers the corners. And even though when I've done some that do have the corners like this, but it's just quite a different style, and when you're not used to it, you kind of tend to gravitate to your own personal tried and true things that you do, these little quirks that you have. So this quirk of mine is having the shelf, even though the sketch does call for a little banner hanging off of that big square that holds a large mat, if you will, I just added more. To me, more is more, more is fun, more is always going to be what brings me joy, and so that's why I added them. I did also bring in these homemade photo corners, and I use them so that I can also highlight this photograph as well. It has the person on the photograph. I am scrapping these for my friend, and so this has my friend Dom here, and I wanted to highlight this photograph of him. It also has this other person here, but that person is not in the photograph, and so to not distract from the photo of Dom, I went ahead and covered that person up. They're not really necessary in the photograph. They don't lend to the story or to who I'm scrapping about, and so it's okay to cover up people that you don't need, or if it's white space in the photo, so to speak. I didn't want to take away from the aquarium part and the fish, and so I just covered the part that had the empty floor space and that person in particular. I didn't want to cover up all the fish is what I'm trying to say. So here I use a tag, and that came from the cut apart sheets, And I had several of these other cut apart pieces from the collection, several collections from Maggie Holmes. I don't recall which ones they are right now. However, I do have several of them in a composition notebook that I had started. And I keep ephemera and cut aparts all together in there. And they're by collector so far right now. So this is a great example of how using multiple collections collectively, see what I did there, go really well. And you can go by mood and feel, but you can also go by color. As long as all the colors kind of correlate to each other and match in your eye, it's all well and swell to use different collections. I think designers design their stuff based on a lot of mood and feel, and so different seasons for different collections. But at the same time, if they use the same kind of color families most of the time, then it's more easier to use as a whole throughout. I hope I just made sense with all that. I am adding several pieces around these photographs. I am making sort of a visual triangle as I'm pointing out here. And even though I don't have three pieces of flair or three pieces of wood veneer, I think that I can also correlate all three visual triangles with certain shapes. Like I have the globe wood veneer on one corner and the top left. On the top, I have a circular flare piece, and then on the left-hand side towards the bottom on that tag, I have a circle piece of ephemera that I also put on dimensional foam. So they don't all have to be the same thing in your cluster, as long as there's either same shape or same relative size, or even the same theme, like the cameras. I made sure I put three different cameras into the clusters. Even though they're three different cameras, it still goes. And so that's what my eye gravitates to. The shapes really call my attention. And then it really calls my attention that they're all cameras. I did hole punch this tag because I wanted to create more texture. And I brought in this baker's twine that goes with the color scheme. Now, my little loop-de-loop was going, I think, to my eye, it seemed like it was going away from the layout or away from the photographs specifically. So then I turned the loop-de-loop going in towards the photograph, and that also helps your eye keep its attention and keep it moving in the right direction, I guess. Or if you want to give it direction, at least you know that your eye is leading in towards the loop-de-loop. It kind of follows the thread into a loop-de-loop into the photographs. I am loving using these sticker books. I don't use them all the time and I don't try to like finish them, but I do love leafing through them and finding little tidbits that I can add to my layout. I felt like this shelf kind of left this Let's Go and the wood veneer hanging, like there wasn't anything really supporting them. And so I added that little scallop sticker as a shelf for those two pieces to kind of be visually held up. They're not just kind of hanging in midair. I also used the sticker book to add a year and the actual title to my whole layout. And you can see me here, I am trying to audition different fonts for the word Canada. Since this is where they are, I felt like that word Canada with the smaller wood grain stickers is a bit small. This one didn't end up working either because it's a bit big. So I feel like a little bit like Goldilocks and the Three Bears with all these flat alpha stickers. And so finally I found this one that said Canada. And then I ended up adding Toronto on underneath. And I hope people from Canada don't come for me, please, people from Canada, because I added Toronto underneath. All I know is that that's where they went. I hope that's where they went. They all say, all the photographs say Toronto from this folder that my friend sent me to scrapbook for him. And so I added the word Toronto. I hope it doesn't like, I hope it's not confusing. I hope it's still okay to add it on after the fact. And here you see me doing the final bits to my layout. I am adding enamel dots, and I also go and add Heidi Swap Color Shine. I added it in the Sweet Mint and the Gold Lame. I have like the last I would say quarter bit or third. Maybe I'm down to a third of that bottle. I plan on using some metallic watercolors that I have, and I have several golds. And that's what I'm going to plan to use for the gold shine sprays. And the Sweet Mint is a newer one that I have in my collection, but I use a little bit of a butter one as well. I didn't even realize. I am pretty glad, going back to the alpha stickers, the flat ones, I'm pretty glad that I found them and that they're multicolor. I didn't mind that too much because there's several colors, but there's not enough, I feel, in the background to overwhelm the title. So I did add the date with my Heidi Swap roller date stamp, and those are pretty much the ending details that I had. Here's that sketch one more time, and here's a second look at my layout as a whole and a close-up of all the details. Don't forget to check out the other ladies that are also participating in the collective. Mine was a bit late, so I apologize for that. But either way, I still hope you enjoyed. Have a great day wherever you are, and stay safe. Bye!